3-1 the final here tonight. The Seawolves over the Huskies. And, Coach, just one of those games where we knew defensively we might struggle a little bit because of the youth that we have back there with Carl Nielsen out. And it seemed like the beginnings of each period we kind of were back on our heels. And that gave the Seawolves a chance to kind of really take it to us for a while there.
Well, they did. And, you know, we talked about that youth on defense. I thought it showed up tonight. And we did not do a good job of the forwards helping our defensemen. And, you know, we have to learn to refocus every period and then come out and have a good first shift and gain some momentum. So it not a good effort. Really disappointed in how we played tonight.
Seemed like, as you expected, the Seawolves putting up just basically a wall in the neutral zone, making it difficult for us to really take in any kind of plays inside of their zone. And I know we were trying to hit that home run pass behind them a couple of times, and they seemed to get on man rushes against us. Was that a concern for you during the game here tonight?
Well, it was. I thought we got away from our systems. You know, we got a little frustrated, and, you know, all of a sudden we're going to try and do it ourselves and play a different way than we need to play to be successful. And we've got to understand that. And when we get away from our game that we had success with, we're not going to have success. And they have to learn that. And that's why I told the team after, you know, when we figure it out per man and how we need to play and we buy in, we're going to be good. But when we don't, we're not going to be very good, and I think you saw that tonight.
And we weren't getting any bounces tonight. A couple of pucks right around the goal line there, and we just could not seem to get it across the net.
Yeah, you know, and you have to pay the price around the net. You have to go to those tough areas to score. I thought the first period we didn't get to the net at all. And then as the game wore on, we got a little bit better. But obviously a little frustrated, a little disappointed. We have to understand a certain way we need to play on the road and limit the goals against. And You know, 2-1 game and a tough call there at the end.
Yeah.
You know, it looked like the original penalty was going to go on them, and somehow we got the original and four, and they get a 4-on-3. And, you know, it's just not a good situation. So we didn't kill it, obviously. And that was the hockey game against a team that plays so well defensively like they do.
Kevin Janot, I thought, really kept us in the game at key times of the game with some outstanding saves on some of those odd man rushes that they had.
Well, no question. I mean, we left them out to dry there a couple times. He made big saves. They hit a couple posts there also.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I think the score flatters us a little bit. And, you know, even though it was a one-goal game there, like I said, we've got to play a lot better. And until we, like I said, figure out how we have to play and buy into it, we're going to be inconsistent, and that's what you're going to see on the road, and we saw that tonight. So very, very disappointed.
Did you know that Lichtai's shot hit the post when it went between? That was back in the first period. Were you aware that actually hit the post? It was so quick, and I know we could see it, but I wasn't sure even if the Huskies knew how close they were to putting that puck in the net.
Oh, yeah, no,
yeah.
We saw
okay.
that. But, yeah, we had some good scoring opportunities, but, you know, like I said, until we figure out we got to play a lot harder defensively, and then we'll get some opportunities. And you're not going to win many games scoring one goal, but you have to limit the goals against, and we got to buy in. And I think we've gotten away from that a little bit.
Was there a little frustration by some of the guys there towards the end there too? I know when you're not scoring goals, it kind of leads to. And again, the penalties were very minor throughout the game until we started seeing the things rack up a little bit towards the end.
Yeah, I don't think we had. We started with a power play all night.
No.
You know, we didn't. You know, and. You know, and that's the way it is. You have to control what you can control, and obviously, you know, you're never going to like the referees anyway, but that's just an excuse. We have to play a lot better, and like I said, we have to understand that we have to play so well and hard without the puck, and then we'll get it more, and then we can do what we're good at. But I just thought we wanted to play a cute, fancy, easy game tonight, and, you know, they're a desperate team.
Yeah.
They hadn't won a WCHA game, and, you know, as a coach, we get to watch the tapes and see that they're a pretty good team. You know, they played Duluth really well for five periods, and until you get in the game, you try and warn your team about that, but obviously they didn't take that advice and understand that, and we have to compete a lot harder.
All right, Coach. Well, thanks for your time. Get some rest, and we'll see you tomorrow night. Good luck tomorrow night against the Seawolves.
Well, thanks, Dirk. I mean, we have a chance to salvage a weekend, and you know, we have to put a much better effort tomorrow night, and I think you'll see us play much harder.
Do you know who you're going with goaltending, or is that still up in the air right
no,
now?
No, Josh Robinson's
okay.
going to get the start. You know, I was leaning and splitting them, and, you know, Kevin, that's nothing against Kevin. He had a good game, but, you know, Josh is off to a good start, and we're going to throw him in tomorrow night, and I know he'll give us a good game.
Thanks a lot, Coach.
You're welcome, Dirk.
Mel Pearson, our Coach's Corner.